He's already got a bit of facial hair. Playful Harry makes case for son Archie Harrison Mountbatten Windsor taking after him as he breaks out dad jokes and ribs giggly Meghan over baby's calm persona in hilarious clip. A delighted Prince Harry cracked out the dad jokes alongside an amused Meghan yesterday when revealing their newborn son Archie Harrison Mountbatten Windsor. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex spoke at a photo call in the grounds of Windsor Castle ahead of a meeting with the Queen, the first member of the royal family to see the child since his birth on Monday. When asked to expose more of their baby's face to the cameras, the Duchess laughed as Harry joked, "He's already got a little bit of facial hair as well, wonderful." As her husband held their son, Meghan said, "He has the sweetest temperament, he's really calm." To which a cheeky Harry replied, "I don't know who he gets that from," before sharing a knowing smirk with his wife. Their baby boy will not have a royal title like Kate and William's children, Prince George, 5, Princess Charlotte, 4, and Prince Louis, 1, but will be known simply as Master Archie after George V limited titles within the family during the First World War. The child's name was revealed on the couple's Instagram account this afternoon, 4 hours after the beaming pair first showed their 7 pounds 3 ounces, 3.2 kilograms, child to the world, during which Prince Harry described him as a little bundle of joy. It's believed that during the intervening period, the couple went to visit the Queen, with Meghan describing it as a nice moment to introduce the baby to more family. And in an image posted yesterday, the Queen, who was also seen earlier at the Royal Windsor Horse Show, is seen happily smiling at the newborn alongside her husband Prince Philip. Baby Archie, who was born at 5:26 a.m. on Monday, is also shown in the black and white image, alongside his grandmother Doria Ragland and parents Harry and Meghan, who has described her first few days of parenting as magic. The youngest addition to the royal family may even share a moniker with his cousin. In January it emerged that Prince George, the eldest son of the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge and future king, also goes by a nickname of Archie. Despite his formal name being George Alexander Louis, the young prince reportedly told a dog walker, "I'm called Archie," while strolling with grandmother Carol Middleton near her home in Berkshire, when he struck up a conversation with the stranger. The Queen and the Duke of Edinburgh met their 8th great-grandchild for the first time at Windsor Castle. Baby Archie was there with his parents and his grandmother, Doria Ragland. Archie breaks with royal tradition in that it's less formal than all the other heir names. Archie is the shortened version of Archibald, meaning bold or brave. Meanwhile, Harrison is of Aboriginal origin and, in a fitting tribute to the baby's father, means son of Henry or son of Harry. The name is a dramatic upset for bookmakers, who had been offering shortest odds on Alexander. Archie was 101 and Harrison made no appearance on their lists. Famous Archies include red-haired cartoon character Archie Andrews from the Archie Comics franchise in America, as well as NFL quarterback Archie Manning. Harrison, meanwhile, has largely been made popular thanks to Star Wars actor Harrison Ford. The couple did not disclose why they had chosen the names, but Archie is an increasingly popular name in Britain. It was among top 20 most common boys' names in 2017, according to the Office for National Statistics. The son of the Duke and Duchess of Sussex will have the hyphenated surname Mountbatten Windsor, in keeping with a royal tradition established shortly after the Queen's coronation. The royal family name of Windsor was confirmed by the Queen after her accession in 1952. But 8 years later she and the Duke of Edinburgh sought a break from tradition to differentiate their direct descendants from the rest of the House of Windsor. The surname had been a thorny issue between the couple, with Prince Philip keen that his surname be used for their children. He famously exclaimed, "I am nothing but a bloody amoeba. I am the only man in the country not allowed to give his name to his own children." It was therefore declared the Queen's descendants, other than those with the style of Royal Highness and the title of Prince, Princess would carry the name of Mountbatten Windsor. This is an amalgam of her name and Prince Philip's surname, which is an anglicized version of the original name of his forebears, the German House of Battenberg, literally, Batten Mountain. Philip's uncle, Lord Louis Mountbatten, fondly named Dickie by the royal family, adopted the anglicized surname during the First World War. His great-grandmother was Queen Victoria and his sister was Princess Alice of Battenberg, Prince Philip's mother. Prince Philip then adopted the surname when he became a naturalized British subject and renounced his Greek and Danish royal titles in order to marry Princess Elizabeth in 1947. Little Archie Harrison Mountbatten Windsor made his very first public appearance at a photo call alongside a thrilled Prince Harry and Meghan in the grounds of Windsor Castle, where the new family have been holed up since the historic birth on Monday. The couple answered several questions before leaving the hall as they prepared to introduce the infant to the Queen yesterday afternoon, where they were expected to inform the monarch of her great-grandson's name before telling the rest of the world. Four candid images, taken by ex-soldier Chris Allerton, were posted to Instagram to share the family of three's first public moment and to announce the little one's name. Together, the two posts gathered more than 4.7 million likes in 8 hours. And just minutes after the name was revealed to the public, royal fans took to social media to share their thoughts. While many were complimentary over the choice, some were a little skeptical, with one saying, "I'm sorry, Archie Harrison? That doesn't sound very royal or British to me." While another added, "The name is American. It's not a very English princely sounding name." And another said, "I was hoping for Spender. Spencer Hamilton sounds royal. But you know, Archie it is." Others were more complimentary over the name choice, with one commentator saying, "So sweet. I love his name, Archie, he sounds positively adorable." And another saying, "Archie is a wonderful name. Also a pleasant surprise. Harry and Meghan are certainly creating their own distinctive identity." Animal welfare charity Mayhew even said it had named one of its kittens Archie, after the royal baby. It tweeted, "In celebration of our patron, the Duchess of Sussex's adorable baby boy, we've named one of our kittens Archie. He's currently 7 weeks old and when he's old enough we'll be looking for a royal household of his own." Later that evening, Harry's cousin Princess Eugenie, who got married to Jack Brooksbank in October last year, congratulated the Duke and Duchess. "I'm just so happy for you. At Sussex Royal," she posted on Instagram, complete with a smiling face with three hearts emoji. The name netted one lucky punter more than £18,000 after she guessed the newest member of the royal family would be given the name Archie. The woman, who has not been named, put £120 on the moniker at 151 after baby Sussex was born on her grandson Archie's birthday, according to bookmakers.tv. She scooped up £18,120 and told the website she plans to put her winnings aside for her grandson. Bookmakers said the name was one of the biggest surprises in royal betting history, with Ladbrokes recording just 60 bets on Archie, while Coral said the name drew just a handful of punters. Alex Apatty, from Ladbrokes, estimated that more than £1 million will be won on all royal baby markets, which also included gender and due date. At the lunchtime photo call, the two-day-old infant was lovingly cradled by his adoring father and watched attentively by Meghan, who was herself pictured for the first time in 6 weeks since withdrawing from public life ahead of the birth. The couple appeared to be beside themselves with joy, giggling and looking into each other's eyes as they spoke, while Harry could not resist sneaking a peek down at his son as he apparently slept. Speaking for only 3 minutes from inside the majestic St. George's Hall at Windsor Castle, a radiant Meghan declared, "It's magic, it's pretty amazing. He's just been the dream, so it's been a special couple of days. I have the two best guys in the world, so I'm really happy. He has the sweetest temperament, he's really calm." The Duke and Duchess risked causing a row between rival media outlets after they insisted on a U.S. broadcaster being present, choosing to include the channel fronted by one of Meghan's best friends, Gail King. By coincidence, or not, CBS's morning show is hosted by Meghan's friend Miss King, who is one of just 20 people to attend her lavish 5-day baby shower in New York, leading to suggestions of favoritism. While the Queen was expected to be the first senior royal to officially meet the newborn, a giddy Meghan revealed how they accidentally bumped into the Duke of Edinburgh in the grounds of Windsor Castle while making their way to the photo call. She said, "We just bumped into the Duke as we were walking by, which was so nice. So it'll be a nice moment to introduce the baby to more family and my mum's with us as well." Asked who the baby takes after, Meghan added, "We're still trying to figure that out." Harry said, "Everyone says that babies change so much over 2 weeks. We're basically monitoring how the changing process happens over this next month, really. But his looks are changing every single day, so who knows?" Asked how he found parenting, Harry added, "It's great. Parenting is amazing. It's only been 2.5 days, 3 days, but we're just so thrilled to have our own little bundle of joy." Harry said they were looking forward to spending some precious times with him as he slowly, slowly starts to grow up. Meghan added, "Thank you everybody for all the well wishes and kindness, it just means so much." The baby is seventh in line to the throne, and the Queen and the Duke of Edinburgh's eighth great-grandchild and the Prince of Wales's fourth grandchild. Shortly after the first photographs surfaced worldwide, royal fans went into meltdown as they declared that the baby looks just like Mama. Others were quick to point out beautiful Meghan looked post-birth, after the Duchess was pictured for the first time in 6 weeks after going on maternity leave from public appearances. In what was seen as a break from royal procedure, the photo call took place 2 days after the birth near Frogmore Cottage, where Meghan has been recovering since Monday alongside her mother Doria Ragland. While the Duchess of Cambridge faced the media outside the Lindo wing of St. Mary's Hospital a few hours after all three of their children were born, American-born Meghan is said to have considered the idea as archaic. Baby Sussex arrived at 5:26 a.m. on Monday, weighing 7 pounds 3 ounces, and is thought to have been born at the Portland Hospital in London, a plush U.S.-owned hospital favored by many wealthy American expats. Meghan, who had been more than a week overdue, is believed to have gone into labor late on Sunday, when she was driven 28 miles away to a London hospital, ending her hopes of a home birth. It comes after Harry and Meghan, 37, insisted that a U.S. broadcaster be present during the unveiling of their baby son, choosing a channel fronted by one of Meghan's best friends. The couple arranged for CBS, the network whose morning show is fronted by the Duchess's confidant Gail King, a guest at her New York baby shower, to join a small British media contingent for the photo call. Miss King was with the couple at their private residence of Frogmore Cottage at the weekend, having arrived in the UK to film what she called a royal special. The show, Meghan and Harry Plus One, is set to air on CBS on May 17, and will feature chats from royal insiders and Meghan's friends to mark the one-year anniversary of the royal marriage and the birth of their first child. It is thought the 64-year-old journalist returned to the U.S. before Meghan was admitted to hospital in the early hours of Monday to give birth. The decision to include a U.S. broadcaster came as a surprise to British television channels including the BBC and ITV, not to mention many at Buckingham Palace. Their inclusion caused a storm among rival media outlets, with the Queen's former press secretary Dick the Arbiter, who comments on royal matters for a host of networks including the BBC, ITV, and Sky, warning it is treading on dodgy ground. Mr. Arbiter said the stated reason, that the inclusion of CBS in the pool means the pictures will make U.S. breakfast shows, was a fatuous excuse because syndication deals would have ensured U.S. coverage without the CBS presence. He alluded to Meghan's close ties to King, saying choosing the U.S. network, fiend, sick, or not, is treading on dodgy ground. Despite CBS's attendance, a royal source said it would not receive any exclusive content from the photo call and would be expected to share all of its material. But the American network's involvement in such a high-profile event usually reserved for British media representatives will still be viewed as a huge scoop stateside. Last night a palace aide said, "There is an international cameraman accredited to the pool facility tomorrow. CBS will provide the cameraman." This reflects the international interest in the story. The international camera spot was self-selected and the pictures will be available for pool use. It came as royal fans patiently waited for their first glimpse of the newborn in a photo shoot, which took place on Wednesday. The event was covered by Sky News, which was selected randomly following other submissions from the BBC and ITV. According to ITV's royal correspondent Chris Shipp, the same process was undertaken to decide which American network would cover the event. He was told CBS was also picked at random following submissions by fellow U.S. broadcasters NBC and ABC. A source said last night the arrangements were made to reflect the international interest in the story. By coincidence, or not, CBS's morning show is hosted by Meghan's great friend Miss King, who is also close to Oprah Winfrey, another a friend of the royal couple and a guest at their wedding. Handily for her, it is expected that footage of baby Sussex will be broadcast in America in time for her popular breakfast show, This Morning. CBS star Miss King was among just 20 guests to attend Meghan's lavish five-day baby shower in New York in February, rubbing shoulders with the likes of Oprah Winfrey and Serena Williams. Senior royals have already spoken about the joy of the new arrival, with Prince William saying on Tuesday he was absolutely thrilled and looking forward to seeing them in the next few days when things have quietened down. He added, "I'm very pleased and glad to welcome my own brother into the sleep deprivation society that is parenting." His wife Kate beamed, as William said, "We are looking forward to meeting him and finding out what his name's going to be, so it's really exciting for both of them and we wish them all the best. These next few weeks are always a bit daunting the first time round, so we wish them all the best." The Prince of Wales has also spoken publicly for the first time about the birth, saying he was delighted at arrival of his latest grandchild. During an official visit to Germany with the Duchess of Cornwall, Charles said on Tuesday, "We couldn't be more delighted at the news and we're looking forward to meeting the baby when we return."